Vanilla. In this video, I'm going to talk about baseload power plants and peak load power plants. We need electricity in our home to power our lights, fan, air conditioner, heater, refrigerator, TV, washing machine, etc. Among these, appliances such as refrigerators run 24/7. We use lights mostly after sunset. Other appliances are switched on only when it is necessary. So if we consider a whole day, the amount of electricity we use in our home throughout the day is not constant. Our households are connected to the power grid to meet all our electricity needs. Not only households, all industries, hospitals, streetlights, restaurants, malls, electric railways, and everything else are connected to the grid. Let's just do a rough calculation of amount of electricity we use throughout the day from midnight. Until around 7 in the morning, the amount of electricity we use will be low as only air conditioners, fans and refrigerators will be in use. After that, the use of electrical power starts increasing as we start our day with a cup of coffee and TV news followed by cooking. By 9 o'clock, when everyone leaves home, the household's electricity demand decreases, while schools, colleges, offices, and industries' electricity demand increases. Later in the evening, when the sun goes down, lights, street lights, and televisions are switched on, which increases the electricity demand. Dinner preparations add to the demand. Around 10 p.m., the electricity demand decreases as people go to bed. This curve is not constant every day. Weekdays and weekends have different electrical usages. Summer, winter, and rainy season have different electrical usages. If you look at this curve, this is the minimum amount of electricity required throughout the day. This power is referred to as base load power. Peak load power refers to electricity use at its highest point during the day. To meet all these demands, the electricity is generated from power plants such as thermal, nuclear, biomass, geothermal, OTEC, hydro, diesel power plants, solar panels, and wind farms. Since demand is not constant, we don't want all these power plants to operate throughout the day. The power plants that are used to meet the baseload demand are called the baseload power plants. And those that meet the peak load demand are called peak load power plants. Power plants that are used during the transition between the baseload and peak load demand are called intermediate load plants. Baseload power plants should operate continuously throughout the day. So, power plants with low operating costs should be used as the baseload power plants. Natural gas and diesel power plants cannot be used as baseload plants as they are expensive to operate. Coal-based thermal power plants use steam to generate electricity. When steam is given as the input, the turbine spins and the generator generates electricity. To produce steam, water is boiled by burning coal. If we have a good stock of coal, we can generate continuous power. Therefore, coal-based thermal power plants are normally used as baseload plants. Similarly, biomass power plants burn wood to produce steam, and nuclear power plants use the heat from the nuclear fission reaction to produce steam. In these two cases too, if we have a good availability of raw materials, then we can generate continuous power. Geothermal energy uses the earth's internal heat to produce steam. This geothermal energy is contained in the rock and fluids beneath the earth's crust. Good geothermal reservoirs produce continuous power. Ocean thermal energy conversion, or OTEC, uses the temperature difference between the ocean surface water and deep ocean water to produce steam. This also provides continuous power. Hydropower plants use hydraulic turbines to generate electricity. The flowing water is given as the input to the hydraulic turbine. There are three types of hydropower: run-of-river hydropower, storage hydropower, and pumped hydropower. In run-of-river hydropower, the natural flow of rivers or streams is used as the input to the hydraulic turbine. During the rainy season, when the river overflows, this energy can be used as baseload power. In storage hydropower, the electricity is produced by releasing water from the dam. This can be either used as an intermediate plant or a peak load plant. Pumped hydropower plants are mainly used during the peak load. This will be discussed later in this video. Solar panels cannot generate electricity at night time and wind turbines cannot generate electricity when there is no wind. That's why they cannot generate continuous power throughout the day. So they are used as intermediate plants. As I said earlier, the diesel and natural gas power plants have high operating cost. So they are used only as the peak load plants. Peaking demands are often for only short durations. So one of the qualities expected from the peak load power plants is that they should have a quick startup time. The best thing about hydropower plants is that it can be started and brought to full power in less than 10 minutes. While thermal power plants require hours to get started, hydropower plants are the best solution for the peak load, especially pumped hydro. When the electricity demand is low, the pumped hydropower plants store energy by pumping water from the lower reservoir to the upper reservoir. During peak load, the water is released back to the lower reservoir, which turns the turbine, thus generating electricity. As you can see, we are relying more on thermal power plants to generate electricity, which is not good for our planet Earth. To reach the net zero goals, we need to replace this with the clean energy solutions such as solar and wind. But they cannot generate continuous power. One of the solutions would be storing the energy when we have excess and using the stored energy when we are in need. I have a video explaining the importance of energy storage and the method of storing energy in the sand. I'm sure you'll enjoy it. Bye, see you in my next video.